Cover bidirectional RNN in this video. If you have not seen my video on simple RNN, which is single direction RNN, then I suggest you watch that because it's kind of a prerequisite. In this video, we'll just discuss theory behind bidirectional RNN. In the future video, we'll cover coding. Say you are working on a named entity recognition problem and you want to figure out the Apple word that we're using is what kind of entity is it. So here, apple is fruit and dhaval is a person. But when you look at a different sentence like this, apple here is a company. It is not a fruit. Now, if you observe the statement carefully, the words which come prior to apple, they are same. So until you look at the sentence after apple, you won't know if apple is a fruit or a company. Now, if you look at your simple RNN, which is a single direction, okay, left to right, then the word apple will have influence only the previous words, which is double loves. Now, people have a common confusion when they look at the graph like this, the picture like this. They think that, you know, it's a 3 and 3, 6, 7 layer neural network. But no, look at this axis. X axis is a time axis. So this is something you have to keep always in your mind, that the actual network is just this. It's a simple network. But we feed word by word. When we get a sentence, we feed every word one by one to this network. And then it kind of has a looping effect. Okay. So when you unroll that in time, you get a network like this. So that thing you need to keep in your mind all the time, that this is a time axis. At time t1, I am feeding word double, getting my activation a1. Then at time t2, when I feed this loves, actually I'm feeding it to the same network, same layer. Okay, so the actual network is this, but since it has a looping effect, I unroll this in time and then I get this picture. Now, simple RNN. Okay, so I'm just gonna show you the simple presentation. So I'm removing all those neurons and everything, and this rectangle box that you see is like a cell. So if it's a simple RNN, it's a simple RNN cell. If it's LSTM or GRU, it's a, you know, LSTM cell or GRU cell. And this is a simplistic representation. But if it's a, you know, the traditional single direction RNN, then the output for word apple will be influenced by all these edges that you see in this different color. So double loves apple. So these are the words that influence the final outcome. But we already saw that in order to decide whether apple is a fruit or a company, you need to look at the words which are coming after apple in the future. So you need to make a change in your neural network for this. So one way you can do this is you add another layer which processes the word from right to left. So think about this layer. Okay, so I already have this, the previous layer, you know, the forward, basically single direction left to right a layer. I add a new layer which is in blue boxes here. So it's a same kind of RNN cells, but the only difference is the activation is going from right to left. Okay, so now what happens is when I decide whether apple is a fruit or a company, see the output y3 hat, that output is a function of a1 and a2. Okay, so basically you have the influence of double loves, the previous words, on your y3 hat. But watch this blue line. But because of this line, now you have influence of your future words as well. So it keeps him healthy. So that sentence will have an impact through this direction, you know, through the direction that goes from right to left. You get all the activation results, and these results feed through this particular arrow, and you can make a decision. So that's all I had for bidirectional RNN. We just covered a basic theory. I did not go into math a little bit. You can maybe check other resources for it. But I hope this video gives you a simple, you know, simplistic understanding of how bidirectional RNN works. In the future video, we are going to cover the vectorization or word embedding techniques, and then we will get into coding. I know in this series so far we have been doing some theoretical videos. You all have been waiting for coding. We'll get to that, but before we get to the coding, we need to cover some essential concepts. So we'll get into word embeddings, and after that we will write code to implement LSTM, GRU, or you know, bidirectional RNN to solve some NLP problems. All right, so thank you very much. Goodbye.